Scanning data sources in Azure Purview requires authentication using either a managed identity or a credential stored as a secret in Azure Key Vault. In this video, we will discuss the steps to provide credentials for scanning data sources in Azure Purview. The six data sources shown on the screen are able to use the Purview managed identity for authentication. For more information on scanning data sources with the Purview managed identity, please see the documentation linked below. There are three activities necessary to create credentials that can be used for scanning data sources in Purview. First, you'll need to create Azure Key Vault connections in your Azure Purview account. Next, you will need to grant the Purview managed identity access to your Azure Key Vault. Once those steps are complete, you will be able to add credentials to Azure Purview. Before you can create credentials, you will first need to associate one or more of your existing Azure Key Vault instances with your Azure Purview account. Let's walk through that process. Log into Azure Purview Studio and click on the button that looks like a toolbox to open the Management Center. In the Management Center, under Security and Access, click on Credentials. On the Credentials page, click on Manage Key Vault Connections. In the Manage Key Vault Connections pane, click on the plus New button. Give your Key Vault connection a name and select your Key Vault from the Key Vault Name dropdown. Note the tip at the bottom regarding granting the Purview Managed Identity access to your Key Vault. Click See More to see details about the managed identity. Click on the managed identity name to copy it to the clipboard for use in the next step. Click Create to complete associating your Key Vault with your Purview account. Click Confirm in the dialog box. Click the Close button in the Manage Key Vault Connections pane. Next, we will need to go to the Key Vault we associated with the Purview account and grant the Purview managed identity the rights to access secrets in that vault. Browse to the Azure portal and select Key Vaults. On the Key Vaults page, click the Key Vault you associated with Azure Purview. In the Key Vault pane, under Settings, select Access Policies. On the Access Policies page, click the link to add an access policy. On the Add Access Policy screen, drop down the menu next to Configure from Template and select Secret Management. Next, to select Principal, click on None Selected. Paste the Purview managed identity copied previously and click on the identity, then click Select. Next, click Add. Finally, click Save to complete adding the Purview managed identity. Before we head back to Purview, I wanted to make note of the secrets we have available in the Key Vault. The Cosmos DB secret contains the account key for my Cosmos DB instance. I will use this secret to create the credential in the next step. Now that we have associated the Key Vault with Purview and granted access to the Purview managed identity, we can continue with creating a credential. To create a new credential, return to Purview and click the plus New button on the Credentials page. Give the credential a name and select the authentication method from the dropdown. There are four credential types supported in Purview today. These are Basic Authentication and SQL Authentication, where you will add the password as a secret in the Key Vault, Service Principal, where you will add the Service Principal key, and Account Key, where you will add the account key as the secret in the Key Vault. In this case, we will select a count key for use with Cosmos DB. We will select the Key Vault from the Key Vault Connection dropdown, then type the name of the secret in the box below. If you have a specific secret version you would like to use, you may enter it here. If you do not enter the version, Purview will use the latest version. To complete creating the credential, click the Create button. Now that we have a credential available, we can use it to scan a data source. In Azure Purview, click the Sources icon on the left. Note that I already have a Cosmos DB data source added, but I have not yet scanned this data source. On the Cosmos DB data source, click on the New Scan icon. In the Credential dropdown, select the credential created previously and click Test Connection. Click Continue and go through the remaining steps to start the scan. In this video, we have walked through the process of associating an Azure Key Vault with Azure Purview and creating a credential that can be used to scan a data source. For more information, please see the official documentation at aka.ms/purviewdocs.